everyone. I wanted to share with you some information about MLA format to help you properly format your papers. You will need this information as you move through your academic career. This can come in very handy for you. So let's look at our margins first of all. The margins are automatically set in Word, or I think in Google as well, to be 1 inch. That's on the top, the bottom, the sides. The only thing that's different from that is this last name and page number, that's a half inch down. The font can be any font that's ordinary. You don't want something that is like Gothic or something that's an ordinary font, and it should be 12 point. So you can use like Times New Roman, Arial, Calibri, Cambria, fonts such as those, unless your professor requires a particular font, you'd want to check with him or her. Now, notice that along this line, the text is left justified. You can see that here. That's the left justified button. So you want to make sure you have that even edge over here and the ragged edge on the right side. Next, here's something you can pay attention to in the title. If you have a two-line title like this, which is correct to do, you always want to have this colon here after the first line. And notice that the main words of the title are capitalized. The first letter is capitalized. The more insignificant words are not capitalized. This is the correct way to do it. You don't want to bold the title or underline the title. You just want it in the regular text with this uniform spacing. And speaking of spacing, note that the whole essay is uniformly double spaced. There are no extra spaces between the heading and the title, or the title and the beginning of the paper, or between the paragraphs. It's all uniform. And let me show you the way to do this in Word. If you hit the paragraph arrow here, you'll see this box and you have choices here. So you want to make sure that your spacing is double. You have choices. You also want to click this box. Don't add a space between paragraphs of the same style. If that box is clicked, you're going to see that this stays uniform. If it is not clicked, you'll get those extra spaces in between your heading and your paragraphs that do not represent proper MLA format. Now let's look at this heading here. There's four elements. Sometimes a teacher will require you to put word count below here, but here are the four elements for MLA format that you should know. Your name here, the name of your professor next, the name of the course afterwards, and lastly the date. There's two correct ways to format the date. This is one of them. Another way to do it would to be, this is like called military style. And you can also do it that way, to April 2017. Next, let's look at this last name and page number in the upper right-hand corner. This is a part of MLA format. And to do this, what you have to do is click Insert. Insert, then you go over to Page Number. You choose Top of Page, and it's going to show you some choices. You're going to click this the right number there. And once you're there, you can type in your last name. Once you're done, you're going to click Close Header and footer, and then that will automatically be ghosted in to that upper right on all pages, and you'll see the numbers are going sequentially afterwards. So next, let's see what we have left. We're going to go down to this block quote here. Now, most quotes, when you integrate them into the text, they're just part of your sentences. They're in between your own words, but when you have a quote that is four lines or longer, you need to make that into a block quote. Now, block quotes are not put into quotation marks because the indentation of the lines in this fashion is a representation of quotation marks. So a reader who sees that type of indented quote will realize it's quoted material, even though it does not have the quotation marks. And you'll notice that the citation is a little bit different here too. Let's look over at this one on the left page. When you are using a citation at the end of a quote, it's normal for the period not to be at the end of the sentence here, but to be put at the end of the citation. However, in a block quote, this rule changes, just to confuse us, I imagine. So in a block quote, there are no quotation marks. There's a period at the end, and then the citation comes afterward as a separate entity there. Now let's go down and look at the Works Cited page. Okay, this, because I changed something up top, I think got messed up. So let's take that out. All right, now we're correct. So we should have a Works Cited title here at the top. It should not be bolded. It should be in the same font as everything else. Everything on the Works Cited page should be uniformly double spaced. No extra spaces. The only difference here is we have this hanging indentation, and what that is for is to make these authors' names or this primary information kind of stick out on the left. So perhaps you're reading the essay and you see, oh, this quote is by Doyle. So you can go down to the Works Cited page and automatically see Doyle and realize that this is the information that the writer was referring to. To get that hanging indentation, you can tab it in. There is another command here in paragraph that you can use under special. See the indentation title and special. So if you highlight your text and click hanging, it will usually format that hanging indentation for you. Another thing you need to notice about the Works Cited page is that the author's last name or whatever information is here first in a Works Cited page will be in alphabetical order. So this is correct. We have Doyle and Yildirim in alphabetical order. And I believe that's it for MLA format. And I hope this helps you as you try to format your papers. If you have any questions, make sure to let me know.